Supreme Week 3 is here. Let's get some bricks. Let's get some bricks. Let's get...
I feel like I'm chosen. I'm covered in gold.
Welcome back, friends, to another edition of Fauntleroy's Finest. Don't worry, folks. I will not be using the megaphone for the whole thing. I'm not going to put you through that. With great power comes great responsibility, yada yada yada, somebody gets shot. You know how it goes. I hope everyone had a great Labor Day weekend with all the barbecues and brew and whatever else that you guys like to do. I know some of you guys like to do that fancy tobacco.
Stop it. Get some help.
Myself and Lady Fauntleroy and the little Fauntleroy, I suppose, went off to Big Bear to visit some friends. We had a great weekend in the woods. We almost were eaten by bears, but we made it out alive. I was able to take a look at this drop list on Sunday. I was not that impressed. So basically, I spent all of my day yesterday building one of these. I figured if I had an infinity gauntlet, I could snap back to when Supreme had some good products and it wasn't a brick week. Apparently, the Lego one isn't real, so I wasn't able to do that. So we're stuck with this week of bricks. It's gone.
That's pretty good.
It is kind of a brick week, but there are some decent items that will be coming out, and I do think a few of them will show some profit down the road. I want to thank all of you guys out there that have subscribed to the channel, and I want to thank everybody that's watching right now that is going to subscribe to the channel. We are dead in the middle of my fishbowl giveaway. If you guys want a chance to win the Supreme Fishbowl that I am giving away, click whatever is right here if you want to see that video. If there's nothing right here, I'll have the link to the video in the description of this video below. So make sure you subscribe and make sure that you watch that video and make the comment that I ask you to make. That's it, and then you'll be eligible for the Supreme Fishbowl. And if you've already subscribed and you want to talk to me a little bit more, jump into the Discord. I'm always around. You can ask questions from me or anyone else in there. Self-promotion aside, let's jump into this week. I am actually very interested to talk about it. Yes, it is kind of a bricky week, but I do think there are some items that are interesting, and I do think there are some items that could make some money down the road.
Okay.
All right, so like normal, I'm gonna go through my top five items of the week. It is a tough one to actually pull five items that I wanna list here. I do have a couple of extra items I wanna talk about as well, so let's jump into it. And my number five item for week three is going to be the small box logo crew neck. I know, nobody likes crew necks anymore. It is what it is. I believe that this item in really good sizes, like XLs and smalls, could do really well. And I do think there are a few colors here that are pretty interesting and you don't see all the time. That mustard colorway, it looks good with the red box logo, and it's like a very Travis Scott colorway because he wears that kind of color a lot, so a lot of his items come out with those kind of colors. I think if you stick with those nice solid colors, you'll be okay. I'm not really sure if I can recommend the one with the pattern on it, but they do sell out faster usually. There are not as many of those made. I don't expect a ton out of this, and again, it might just sit at retail for the rest of its life because it isn't really much more than a crew neck with a small box logo on it. Why I put this as number five is because it's an extremely wearable item, and again, they will sell out pretty quickly. Okay, so for my number four pick, I'm actually gonna go with this track panel zip-up hooded sweatshirt. I really like the light blue brown colorway. I think it looks amazing. And to be fair, each of the colors look really nice on their own. I don't hate any of them. Specifically though, if you can grab this blue one in an XL or a small, I think you're gonna see some decent profit on that one. If I grab one, I may grab it in my size because I'm getting to the point where I'm going to want a new jacket, and I actually do really like this one. Either way, the good sizes, XLs and smalls, should do well in pretty much all of these, but the light blue one is for sure the grail of this particular set. Okay, for my number three item, I'm actually gonna go with this photo printer. The reason is, I don't think there's a lot of resell in it, but I do think it's a cool item. Most of the stuff that has anything to do with any kind of technology does not age well. Even this printer, it's only a 300 DPI printer, so the quality of the prints aren't really going to be that great. What is really cool is you can take a picture and then just print it, like from your phone. It's Wi-Fi, Bluetooth enabled. I don't believe you can just go to the store and buy an extra roll of paper for these. I think you have to like either go to a store that sells these type of cameras or buy it from their website. I don't think you're going to make a ton of money off of these, if anything. I just think it's kind of a cool item. That's why I threw it in here at number three. Okay, for my number two item, this might be the highest that I've ever ranked a premium tee in the history of my life.
What?
This Gons name tag tee, I think it's a really nice one, and I do think that you're gonna see this being the cheaper end of the premium tee spectrum, so probably somewhere around like $70 to $80, which is still really, really high. So you just generally are never going to make that much off of any of these premium tees. But again, I think this is a good one. I think a lot of people want this tee to wear. But I think anytime that you go in and buy a t-shirt that's already $70, you're taking a risk. So kind of similar to the last item. I like it. I think it's a cool item. Do I think it's going to resell for a lot of money? Probably not. I don't think it's the craziest item. I don't think it's going to be the most hype item, but I do think people like it. I do think people are going to want it. I do think the good colorways and sizes will definitely sell out in this one. So if you're interested in it, I think this is a great item to try. Sadly, though, my number one item for this week are going to be hats. I'm going to just put these two different hats up there for my number one items. The first one is this military camp cap. These things are amazing. These do really well. For the military camp cap, I'd say go with the black or the navy. Those are my two favorite colors. I like the navy because it has that pop of yellow on the side, so it can go with like the Michigan colorways or something like that. But black is the safest, and then I think, yeah, that navy one is nice. The digi camos are fine, but they don't really ever do as good as just the solid basic colors that people can wear anywhere. And then the wax cotton camp cap, that thing is also gonna do really well, and I think specifically the black and the green ones, I think they're really clean and they look really nice. You don't see a lot of those deep green colors as well. They're very, very nice hats, and they do really, really well on the aftermarket. So honestly, the wax cotton should be your focus. We have a visitor. She wants to say hello.
Hey, y'all. I like the green one. I like the black one, all right. I don't dig the purple, nor do I dig the two-tone.
You don't like that navy one?
If you're a Cowboys or, listen, maybe even a Dodger fan. I actually kind of dig also on the end, the red with the white.
I don't like white hats. I wear my hats and they get dirty really quickly. Yeah. She makes some sense there. The green one, I think, looks good because you just don't see that color that much, that nice dark green. And then the black one will always be the best one to go after. I'm not a huge fan of the other ones, really. The brown one, maybe, but I just don't like that it's two-tone as well. So there you go. That is basically my top five. When hats are on top of the list, it is not a good week at all. I do have a couple of other items that I'm kind of interested in. This eyes hooded sweatshirt. It kind of looks like a ripoff of like the old Bad Boys, or to me, it kind of looks like the Grinch's eyes or something, but it's interesting. It doesn't say Supreme on it, so it probably won't resell, but I do think that it's neat, and these will probably never come around again, so this should be a one-of-a-kind type of an item. And then they do have another faux fur item. The last faux fur item actually did pretty well, sold out immediately, and for last I checked, it's like reselling for $100 more than what it was. No idea why. Those are horrendous items, but it went really fast. I figure I should mention these two-tone faux fur shop jackets. The bluish one actually isn't that bad. Again, like in big sizes, you'd probably do okay with these jackets. Anything like this is really a huge risk, and you're probably gonna have to hold it till it gets a little bit colder when people are wanting jackets. Also, another really cool shirt is this bridge embroidered short sleeve top. This entire thing is embroidered on the shirt. It's kind of amazing, honestly. And it's got like the Supreme Subway at the bottom, the Statue of Liberty, bridge has Supreme on it, all stitched in, all embroidered in. If that clown sequins shirt sold out last week, this one will sell out as well. It actually is a pretty cool shirt, the black one anyway. So I don't know. That is also maybe something to take a flyer on, grab it, throw it in the closet. Maybe it's worth something one day. And then obviously they are going to drop these spinner dub rims. I can't imagine these are anything other than friends and family. I assume you can walk into the store this week. There wasn't a registration, so it's just wait in line and see. I'm sure they're extremely expensive, and I'm sure they're friends and family only, but they are releasing this week, so there you are. All right, guys, so there you have it. It is kind of a brick week. If you were planning to take a vacation from Supreme, this might be the week to do it. But if you do get up on Thursday and decide to buy stuff from them, good luck to you. I hope you can get everything that you want. It shouldn't be too terribly difficult this week. I'll have another live cop and unboxing for you at the end of this week. But until then, bye-bye, and I will see you guys next video. I've been working as great.